Alright, what is up guys? I am Toucan and today I will be teaching you guys how to make a thumbnail. This thumbnail tutorial is going to be geared towards mostly the gaming genre, but it can be applied to other video genres as well. Okay, what is the importance of having a good thumbnail? I believe that a thumbnail is the first thing someone sees. If you see an interesting thumbnail and it grabs your attention, you're gonna be like, whoa, I'm interested, I wonder what this video is about. And then you're gonna watch the video and boom, there you go. So, some important things to consider about thumbnails is you don't wanna have too many words on it because the chances of people actually taking their time to reading a whole paragraph thumbnail is very slim. So you want to make it around max maybe 4 words or 2-3 words. It's up to you, but just don't put too much. It should also convey the idea of your video. So if you're making a gaming video, then you want to kind of make your thumbnail imply that it's a gaming video. So with that being said, basically what we're going to be doing is creating this thumbnail right here that I made moments ago and making something similar to it. I will have the PSD in the description down below if you guys want to download the template and, you know, see if you can mess around with it and see what you can do with it. But I suggest you guys follow the tutorial so you can make your own thumbnails and you can kind of create your own sort of style to them. Alright, so let's begin. First, what you want to do is you want to make file. You want to make a new file. You can name it whatever you want. I'm just going to name it thumbnail tutorial. The size needs to be 1920 by 1080. The resolution, you can keep at 72 unless you're printing. If you're printing, then you're going to do 300. Chances are you're not going to be printing, so 72 is perfect. Color mode, RGB color. Again, if you're printing, CMYK is a very, very good option for printing. Keep it at 8-bit. You really won't need anything else. Background contents, this really doesn't matter. You can have whatever. It's going to be changed later because we're going to use a screenshot. Click OK. So now we have the file set up. What are you going to need? Well, for this, what I used was a screenshot of someone in Call of Duty holding a gun. And some other things you're going to need is an overlay pattern. So all you need to do is just go to Google and type black and white overlay pattern, and you're good to go. Pick something you like. You can use it. I already have what I want selected, so I'm just going to go into my file, drag these two in here. All right. So I'm just going to make this invisible for now. So, all right, let's get to work. Now, what you want to do first is we want to make an outline of this gun with the pen tool. So get the pen tool, zoom in as much as you need. You just basically want to get the general idea of the shape. So just use your pen tool and trace the outer parts of the gun and the hands and whatnot. You don't have to be like very precise. You can be approximate, something quick, unless you want to go insanely accurate, which a lot of people won't notice the difference unless they zoom in a lot. So here we go, just quickly slap on them shapes. Now, if you're having trouble with the pen tool, I will be making a separate tutorial on the pen tool itself because the pen tool is very, very, very important for designing, especially if you want to get into logo designs, making icons and such. It's a very, very important tool. and it will make your, if you understand it, it will make your life so much easier. So as you can see, I'm kind of curving some of my edges just to kind of go for those circular shapes and to make them more circular rather than kind of clicking and trying to make it circular. So here we go. So this kind of knocks out the whole kind of clicking, click, 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 click to get that circular rounded corner look. Here we go. We are almost good. So I'm gonna pause the video and I'm gonna come back once I am done outlining. All right, so we have our areas selected that we want to use. So once you have that down, all you want to do, or all you need to do is right click, make selection, feather radius 0, and click OK. Now what you're going to do is Control C to copy and Control V to paste. Now you have another gun. So what you want to do, you kind of line this up with the other gun, Control T and size it to make it a little bit bigger. By a little, I mean a lot. So here we go. This looks around good. So what we want to do is double click on our duplicated gun to bring up the blending options or the layer style. So what you want to do is add a stroke, and I usually make my strokes around 6, make it white. I'm gonna add a drop shadow, make the drop shadow pretty strong so it gives it a little bit more pop. Distance, I keep the distance at 0, so you can make the spread 15, size 80, and let's do inner glow. Let's make the size a little bit bigger, and let's try a couple of soft light. All right, soft light looks all right. You don't have to make this too major. Just do around 20 size. It'll be okay. So now that we got that out of the way, what we want to do is we want to kind of change the background, so this image right here, into sort of a purplish color. So what you need to do for that is I'm just going to slap on a gradient map. And go in here, make the color purple, and make this purple as well. Let's see. Make this purple a little darker. Okay. Make this an overlay. So now you're gonna have this funky looking color. That's all right. And let me just move around my gun. Alright, now we want to add in some text. So get your text tool, thumbnail. Now you can type whatever you want, but since this is a thumbnail video and that's really loud, you're gonna get thumbnail. Now we're gonna also put tutorial. Awesome. Line that up. I'm gonna select both of those if you want to make them kind of centered together. Select both the layers and click up here. Okay. Oops. Keep clicking like everything except what I want to click. So I'm just gonna move these around. And all right, I want to make this bottom text, so the tutorial, I want to make it kind of like a goldish sort of yellow. Yeah, this seems around what we want. Awesome. So now what we need to do, we want to double click on, or we want to select both of these two layers. We're gonna make new layers. So we're going to duplicate both of those, rasterize the layers, and then we're going to merge the two layers together to make one single layer. Now that you've got that done, you want to double click on the copy. We want to add a drop shadow, zero distance, make the size give or take around 40, spread 10 should be good. Now what we're going to do, we're going to add a satin, I believe it's how you say it. We're going to make it overlay, and we're going to adjust a little bit the opacity, 70, distance, let's make that 12, the size 16. Now we're going to go to inner glow. We're going to change the color of the inner glow to more of a bright yellow. So if we go off to the side, okay, okay. Size, make it 24. Looks good. Click okay. There we go. Now we want to inflate the text. So we want to warp it. So what you need to do that is you want to select the layer, Control T, right click, warp. Once you have the warp, you're going to see an option for, you know, cut or drop down for custom. Click it, go down and do inflate. Now this is too much of a bend. What we want to set it to is around 30. Here we go. Perfect. Now you want to apply it and you're good. So I'm going to make a new folder for the text. So text, and what we're going to do is we're going to put all of our text into here. So now we need to duplicate these and kind of make it so the text is a little 3D effect. So we're going to select this, we're going to duplicate it, and now what we're going to do is Control T, Shift, Alt, and then drag down. You want to drag it down a little bit, not too much. Okay. Duplicate the duplicated layer. And same thing, Control T, Shift, Alt, and drag down a little bit. And I think it's a little too much. Oops. That should be good. Cool. Now what we're going to do is we got the text, we got the background and whatnot. Now let's add some more sort of effects. What we're going to do is we're going to use adjustment layers. We're going to go into curves, just the curves. We're going to make it a little darker. Okay. We're going to add, let's add another gradient. As you can see, that's pretty strong. I'm going to make it the one of the default ones they have, which is the purple to orange. Awesome. This is going to be overlay as well. So it gives it nice, deep, rich sort of colors. And on top of that, I'm going to add a hue and saturation. And let's make it sort of, purple, like we have on the other one. And these two, we're going to drag these two adjustment layers below the text. So we have this. Awesome. Let's zoom out. Cool beans. Now that we have these two, what we're going to do is we're going to go to the text. We're going to sort of flip it to give it that little, you know, little kick. I'm not sure how to describe that, but yeah, I feel now that the gun or the text might be a little too big. So size it down a little bit. Awesome. You can put the text wherever you want. If you want to put it down in the corner, up here, whatever looks best, that's up to you. So I'm just going to kind of put it in the center for now. Now what we need to do is we're going to add top bars. Now these bars are just going to be, or actually let's add our pattern now. So now that we got our pattern, bring the pattern above the gun layer. Control T, to adjust the size. Get it like this. Boom. Perfect. Now this is going to be subtract. There we go. Maybe if we just bring it below the text. Or no, keep it above the gun layer. Now lower the opacity. 30 will be fine, around 30, maybe even 20. Let's go to 20. Awesome. All right, so now what we want to do is add a top bar. So we're just gonna get a yellowish color for the top bar to make it the same around purple, like the text. New layer, put that in there. Awesome, we're gonna lower the opacity on this. 50 should be good, around 50. Now duplicate that, bring it to the bottom. Awesome, and let's add another gold layer. Now it's just gonna be fully gold this time. So here we go. Bring the opacity of that down as well. Make it around 15%. Awesome, now let's adjust the text, move it up a little bit. Now double click on one of the bars. You want to add a stroke, and 3 should be fine. Make it like a bright purple color. Or gold, I mean, because that would turn out the color to be purple. Awesome. Souls 100%. You can't see it. Oh no. How about let's make that even brighter? Okay, bring that on the inside. It's not showing up like I thought it would. And let's just put it out white then. And put it outside. Cool. Now you want to do right click, copy layer style, paste layer style to the top one. So we didn't do it. Oh, we accidentally copied the other one. So copy, paste, voila. So right now this would be okay, but we're gonna add a little bit more effects to make it look a lot better. Now I know this video is a little bit long, but that is fine. It's well worth it in the end. So what I'm going to do is I'm gonna make a new layer, grab the brush tool, one of the brush tools, and what I'm basically gonna do is get a purplish sort of color. So right here, it's fine. We're gonna size this to be a little bit bigger. There we go, perfect. Now what we're gonna do, we're gonna make this layer an overlay, kinda dot around with where you put that. Now adjust it, make it like 50%, that's fine. And you basically have a thumbnail. Now I hope you guys like this video. This video was a little bit longer, but this is basically the basics on how to do this sort of effect. Now you can obviously add on to it and do what you want to do with it. I will also have the download link in the description if you want to download it and, you know, work with it yourself, that's fine. Hope you guys enjoyed. Peace out and bye.